I love you, Allah.
Inna Allah la ghaniyun 'anil 'alamin. Listen to this carefully. He said, Allah has no need of any people of all, any of the nations. Allah doesn't need you or me. Allah doesn't need my prayers. Allah doesn't need my du'as. Allah doesn't need me to stay away from haram things. Allah doesn't need me to control my tongue. Allah doesn't need me for anything. If I am doing those things, I've only done them for my own benefit, for my own self. That is Allah's teaching. And then he says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَنُكَفِّرَنَّ عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَحْسَنَ الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And those who have faith and do good deeds, what that means is even when they're going through a really hard time, they hold on to their faith and they don't let go of good things. They don't let go of prayer, for example. The first good deed is prayer, right? Because when people go through a tough time, they stop praying. I don't feel like it. I don't know, something stops me from praying. When you do that to yourself, you're cutting your connection to Allah off. That prayer is what helps you in your life. It's what gives me and you the strength in our hearts to deal with all of our problems. You're cutting off your medication. You're cutting off your own medication. I'm cutting off my own medication, but we're not praying anymore. Even if you feel like, I don't feel anything when I pray, doesn't matter, just hold. Even if it becomes thin like a thread, like it feels like it's barely there, don't let go of the prayer. It'll become stronger later, it's fine. Don't let go of it. If you barely feel like praying, at least pray the fuck. Just do some, don't skip a prayer. Don't do it. Don't do that to yourself. Because you're harming yourself. Allah says, if you can do that, لَنُكَفِّرَنَّ عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَحْسَنَ الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. We will bury away their sins. The mistakes they made will be gone, will be completely buried. Allah guarantees that. And He says, we will compensate them with the very best of what they used to do. Understand this beautiful promise from Allah. We've done some good things in life, we've done some bad things in life. And sometimes we've done some pretty great things. Maybe one day you caught a Laylatul Qadr. You don't even know. Or maybe one day you did such a remarkable good deed. Not every day, but that one day in your life you did something pretty amazing. If Allah buries away your sins and you can hold on to His faith, you know what He does? Let me give you by example. You know, sometimes in a class, in a semester, in like math class, there are 5 exams, right? And one exam you scored a 20, one exam you scored a 60, one exam you scored a 50, one exam you scored 100, miraculously. And the teacher says, I will take your highest score and I will make that your entire grade. I won't average everything, I'll just take your highest score and that's your grade. You're like, wow, that's awesome. That's exactly what Allah is saying. Allah is saying, if you can survive with your faith, and if you don't abandon your faith and you do good things, you don't let go of good things, then I will take the very best things you've ever done and I will give you the reward based on your very best. Like, He won't gauge us on every prayer. The bonus here is He will give us reward based on the very best salah you ever had in your life. And it's as though that was every single salah in your life. SubhanAllah. That's when a person holds on to their faith when times are hard, this is what Allah rewards them with.